Thanks for watching another Rivage PM training video. We've got the console connected to the DSP engine. Now we're going to show you how to use TWINLANe to connect all the RPio units in a redundant ring. But firstly, what is TWINLANe? It's a high quality, high capacity audio transport mechanism using a redundant fibre optic ring to connect, control and synchronize multiple audio devices. And it has incredibly low latency, just 12 samples at 96 kHz, which is about 0.1 milliseconds. It will carry 400 audio channels at any sample rate between 44.1 and 96 kHz, and it uses a 32-bit depth for extra dynamic range. And of course, it has the capacity to carry all the control and level metering data between the DSP engines and the RPio units. Let's take a look at the TWINLANe connections. There are two types of fiber module and cable available: single mode and multi-mode. Select your preferred one depending on cost and distance between devices. Multi-mode will save a little cost, but will have a 300 meter limitation between each device, while single mode will allow cable runs up to 2 kilometers. However, the maximum cable length in one ring is limited to 6 kilometers to keep the latency low enough. Once you've chosen your cable type, it's important to make sure each TWINLANe device has the same module type installed, because you need to connect them in a redundant ring. Choose either the HY256TL multi-mode card for all devices in the system, or the HY256TL SMF card, and install them into HY slot 1 of each device. Connect from out to in, until the ring is complete. You can have up to 8 RPio units in one TWINLANe ring. Then you should make sure each one has a different ID number on their front panel, from M1 to M8. You can also have up to 4 DSP engines in the same ring, 8 engines if you're using mirror mode redundancy for all the engines. Anyway, if you want front of house, monitor consoles, recording and broadcast, all sharing the same I/O racks, then you can make such a system. Make sure each engine has a different ID number from 1 to 4. You don't need to connect them in exact numerical order, by the way. But once they are connected, you can synchronize with the console. If the device sync screen doesn't appear automatically on the console, then open the setup menu and then you can find it here. Now choose the sync direction carefully. If the input gain and phantom power settings are already programmed in the console, set the arrow to the rack. But if the IO rack is already set, perhaps by another console, then set the arrow to sync to this console. Once that's done, you can check your system status in the system config page, also in the setup menu. Look at HY slot 1. If the TWINLANe line is green, you have a successful redundant ring. If it's yellow, there's a break somewhere, but it will still be working. Touch each RPio unit or DSP engine to have a look at the optical power of each fiber connection. This is really useful for troubleshooting. If it's green, it's good. If it's yellow, it's borderline. You should clean your cable carefully when you have a chance. If it's red, the quality of light is too low. The cable may be damaged or the connection not made correctly. We would expect a light power of between 100 and 300 microwatts, depending on the cable length and type. But the lowest acceptable level showing green is 49 microwatts for multi-mode fiber and 11 microwatts for single mode. By the way, if 8 RPIO units is not enough, or if a single ring topology doesn't suit the venue layout, then I bring more good news. Each DSP engine can support 2 TWINLANe rings. Use the main ring to connect multiple DSP engines together with their shared RPIO units. Then create a sub-ring for individual DSP engines using HY slot 2. This is not possible with the RIVAGE PM7 though, because its internal DSP engine has only 3 HY slots. PM7 only supports the main TWINLANe ring. Though any of the DSP engines used by PM3, PM5 and PM10 will support a sub-ring using HY slot 2. Use it for local connections with an RPIO 222, for example, or use it to connect with a second stage with up to 8 extra RPIO units. Anyway, it provides a lot of possibilities, as each TWINLANe card will provide 256 audio connections in and out of each device. Though remember the 400 channel limit in each ring. So we'll look at how to configure that in another video soon. And understand that audio channels can be transferred directly from one ring to another using the DSP engine's port-to-port patch bridge. We'll leave that more advanced function until much later in this series, though. But next time, we'll look at how to use Dante with RIVAGE PM systems and how to control various devices in the Dante network. Which reminds me of a frequently asked question. Why use TWINLANe rather than Dante? After all, both can work at 96 kHz with 32-bit depth. Well, there are 3 main reasons. 1, bandwidth, because TWINLANe can handle 256 channels in and out of each device, along with control data and level metering. Though, a Dante network can carry that much data, there's no module that can deliver it all at once. 2, a redundant ring can be created without needing any network switch or other external device. 3, TWINLANe works with a lower latency than Dante can practically provide. Though, as we'll see next time, Dante is better at connecting with many distributed, lower channel count IO devices. See you soon.